In this video, you will learn about several project-based applications for your Chromebook classroom. Keep in mind that applications evolve, and this and all video modules will be updated as needed. The first one that we're going to go over is project-based applications. Something within project-based applications is Synth. Synth is a beta version and used to be Recall. In a letter to consumers, Recall stated that they decided to come out with something unlike Flipgrid. Synth allows you to create a podcast and share it with others to listen to or continue the conversation. It is both an app and a web-based application. For the Chromebook, the web-based application should be best. Synths are searchable and scannable. You can use threads, hashtags, and comments to have open, real-time conversations or in an experience you synthesize using podcasts. In order to use it on your Chromebook, you would go to this URL, you would get started on the web, you would continue with your Google sign-in, and then you would either introduce yourself, or you would get an overview of it, or you would play all your synths. In order to start a new one, you would hit the plus button. You would then start, and you could then upload the audio as well. You may also invite one or many participants to the podcast. You could discuss a topic on a one-time or ongoing basis, and you can keep it private for participants only or make it all discoverable. You could listen to your feed, a search topic, or a podcast back-to-back. The next application is Book Creator. It once was an app, but now it is an app as well as web-based. If you go to bookcreator.com, you'll see up here, wherever I'm toggling right here, you can choose Chrome. You're able to watch a video or get started for free. Book Creator allows you to create books online. It will be as fully featured as the iPad version. With Book Creator, one can add text messages by starting a new book. You can choose whichever book shape you would like. You can also see that some of them are comic. You can add text, images, drawings, shapes, audio, and video. You can also publish and share books online with their new web-based reader. You can work collaboratively and combine books from multiple authors. And you can access all your books on any device. The next application is Canva. To log on, you log in with your Google. Canva allows students and yourself to create digital posters, invitations, flyers, social media posts, and more on their web-based application. It makes design easy. You can create a design, and you can decide what you would like to have. Canva has a lot of ready-made templates that will always be here on the left. They have photo grids and ideas already within the program to ignite ideas. They also have text, images, and links to your design. You can download an image as a PDF or share the project online. I will use an actual infographic that I made. As you see, if I click share, it will have me type in email addresses or people that I want to invite to edit it, so you can work collaboratively on this. You can also click download, and when you click download, you'll notice you'll have several options. They will tell you that if you have anything that has links on there, that it would be better to make it a PDF instead of a PNG, so they'll always give you different things to choose from, but they'll always give you this option too, and then you'll download it. Once downloaded, it will come on your desktop or in your files, and then you'll be able to upload it to Drive or share it with others. In the next video, you'll learn about brainstorming apps for Chromebook.